क्वेश्चन नंबर 14। कैलकुलेट कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग। प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर इज गिवन 7 लाख आफ्टर कंसीडरिंग द फॉलोइंग आइटम्स। डेप्रिसिएशन, गुडविल एमोर्टाइज्ड, गेन ऑन सेल ऑफ लैंड एंड एप्रोप्रिएशन टुवर्ड्स जनरल रिजर्व। देन द पोजिशन ऑफ करंट एसेट्स एंड करंट लाइबिलिटीज इज गिवन। ओपनिंग बैलेंस एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंसेज आर गिवन। सो लेट अस प्रिपेयर कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज। कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज। ओके, लेट्स बिगिन विथ द प्रॉफिट। इट इज गिवन हियर, प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर इज गिवन 7 लाख रुपीज। प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर इज गिवन 7 लाख। व्हाट वी ऐड एट द बिगिनिंग, एप्रोप्रिएशन एंड ओनली वन एप्रोप्रिएशन इज गिवन। एप्रोप्रिएशन ऑफ प्रॉफिट टुवर्ड्स जनरल रिजर्व 60,000। सो लेट्स ऐड ट्रांसफर टू जनरल रिजर्व। Transfer to general reserve is 60,000, isn't it? When we add, what we get? That profit before tax, and extraordinary items are not given. So 7,60,000 is your net profit before tax. Then what we add? We add non-cash expense. Let's see, non-cash expenses are given or not. Yes, given. Depreciation 40,000. So depreciation is given 40,000. This is non-cash expense. Goodwill amortized is also given 20,000. Goodwill amortized 20,000. Then we need non-profit expenses, which is not given. Gain on sale of land is non-operating income. What we do? We subtract non-operating income. Non-operating income. That is gain on sale of land is given 90,000. Gain on sale of land 90,000 will be subtracted. Okay, so when we solve this, what we get? Let me calculate. 7,60,000, 7,60,000 plus 60,000 plus 60,000 minus 90,000 minus 90,000. So 7,30,000. So this 7,30,000 will be known as operating profit before working capital changes. Is that clear? Operating profit before working capital changes. Now we need to do some adjustment for working capital. Hai na? Adjustment for working capital. So let's see what is given. Trade payables are decreasing. Decrease in trade payable 25,000. Decrease in trade payable is current liability 25,000, and decrease in current liability will be subtracted, hai na, reduced. Then trade receivable, increase in trade receivable. Trade receivable is current asset. Increase in trade receivable. Trade receivable is current asset, and increase in current asset will be subtracted. It is 15,000. 15,000 will be subtracted. Then prepaid expenses. Decrease in prepaid expenses 8,000. Decrease in prepaid expenses 8000 it is current asset, and when current asset decreases, cash increases 8000. So all points are over. Let's do the total. Let me do the total. 730 minus 40,000 plus 8,000 is equal to 698,000. 698,000. So this is your cash flow from operating activities. So children, I hope this question is clear to everyone. Question number 15. Okay. So let's start. Yes, question number 15. Charles Limited earned a profit of rupees 1 lakh after charging depreciation of 20,000 on assets and transfer to general reserve of 30,000. Goodwill amortized was 7,000. Gain on sale of machinery was 3,000. Other information available. Changes in the value of current assets, current liabilities. Trade receivable increased 3,000. Trade payable increased 6,000. Prepaid expenses increased 200. Outstanding expenses decreased 2,000. Okay, so let's begin. We need to calculate cash flow from operating activities. Hai na? So let's prepare. Question number 15. Cash flow from operating activities. So let's begin. What is given in the beginning? Profit is given of rupees 1 lakh. So profit is given 1 lakh of the year. Then we need to add some appropriations. So in this question, there is only one appropriation which is given, that is general reserve. Hai na? So transfer to general reserve. Transfer to general reserve 30,000. When we add, what we get? 1,30,000. So this is our net profit before tax. Extraordinary items are not given in the question. Okay. And then what we add? Then we add non-cash expense. Let's see. Non-cash expenses are given or not? Yes, it is given. Depreciation 20,000 rupees, hai na? This is non-cash expense. Depreciation 20,000 rupees. Goodwill amortized, this is also non-cash expense, 7,000 rupees. Goodwill amortized, hai na? 7,000 rupees. 7,000 rupees. Then what we add? Non-operating expenses. Non-operating expenses are given or not? It is not given. But gain on sale of machinery is given. That is non-operating income. So non-operating expenses are not given. Then we subtract non-operating income. Non-operating income. Non-operating income is given. What is given? Gain on sale of machinery 3000. Gain on sale of machinery 3000. That will be subtracted. Okay. When we add all these points, what we get? 1,50,000 plus 7000 minus 3000 is equal to 1,54,000, and 1,54,000 is our operating profit before वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस, ओके 1,54,000. नाउ व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू डू सम एडजस्टमेंट फॉर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस. एडजस्टमेंट फॉर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस, करंट एसेट्स एंड करंट लायबिलिटीज आर गिवन. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज गिवन. ट्रेड रिसीवेबल शोड एन इंक्रीज ऑफ 3,000. सो इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल. ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इज करंट एसेट है ना, एंड व्हेन देयर इज इंक्रीज इन करंट एसेट इट मींस कैश गोज आउट. हाउ मच? 3,000 रुपीज. सो इट विल बी रिड्यूस, कैश गोज आउट, दिस इज आउटफ्लो. देन ट्रेड पेबल एंड इंक्रीज ऑफ 6,000, इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड पेबल, इंक्रीज इन ट्रेड पेबल. ट्रेड पेबल इज करंट लाइबिलिटी एंड इंक्रीज इन करंट लाइबिलिटी मीन्स इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश 6,000 प्लस प्रीपेड एक्सपेंसेस एंड इंक्रीज ऑफ रुपीज 200, इंक्रीज इन प्रीपेड एक्सपेंसेस, इंक्रीज इन प्रीपेड एक्सपेंसेस. प्रीपेड एक्सपेंसेस आर करंट एसेट्स, इंक्रीज इन करंट एसेट्स मीन्स आउटफ्लो है ना. सो 200 रुपीज आउटफ्लो. देन आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस अ डिक्रीज ऑफ 2,000. सो डिक्रीज इन आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस, डिक्रीज इन आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस. आउटस्टैंडिंग एक्सपेंसेस आर करंट लाइबिलिटी, करंट लाइबिलिटीज आर डिक्रीजिंग इट मीन्स इट इज आउटफ्लो, इजंट इट? बाय हाउ मच? बाय 2,000 रुपीज. आउटफ्लो ऑफ रुपीज 2,000 बिकॉज करंट लाइबिलिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग. All points are over, okay? So let's do the total. So 1,54,000 minus 3,000 plus 6,000 minus 2,200. So it is coming 1,54,800. This is your cash flow from operating activities. I hope it is clear to everyone. Question number 17. Sunrise Limited reported net profit after tax of rupees 6,40,000. For the year ended 31st March, the relevant extract is given. Current year, previous year is given. Inventories, trade receivable, prepaid, trade payable and provision for tax is given. Depreciation charged on plant and machinery 55. Insurance claim received 50,000. Gain on sale of investment 20,000. Calculate cash flow from operating activities. Okay, let's start. Cash flow from operating activities. Okay, so what is given? Net profit after tax is given 6,40,000. Net profit after tax is given 6,40,000. We need to adjust some provision. Provision for tax is given here. So what we do? We take current year provision for tax. Hai na? So first we add provision for tax of current year. How much it is given? 20,000. So 20,000 will be added. Any other provisions or adjustment are given? Nothing is given. Hai na? So 6,40,000 plus 20, 6,60,000. Then extraordinary expenses, let us check, not given. But extraordinary income is given, insurance claim received. Hai na? So what we do? We subtract extraordinary income एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी इनकम, इंश्योरेंस प्रोसीड्स, हाउ मच? 50,000. 50,000, सो 6,60,000 माइनस 50, 6,10,000, सो दैट विल बी योर नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स एंड एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी आइटम. देन वॉट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू एड नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस. लेट्स सी नॉन कैश एक्सपेंसेस आर गिवन और नॉट इन द क्वेश्चन. Depreciation is given, which is non-cash expense, 55,000. Depreciation, 55,000. It is non-cash expenses, and non-cash expenses are added. Then non-operating expenses are not given, but gain on sale of investment is given, 20. It is non-operating income. So non-operating incomes are subtracted. So let's subtract the non-operating income. Gain on sale of investment, 20,000. Gain on sale of investment, that is 20,000. Let us subtract it, hai na? Let's see what we get. So 6,10,000 plus 55,000 minus 20,000, 6,45,000. This is considered as operating profit before working capital changes. So we have reached on second stage, operating profit. Now we need to do some adjustment for working capital changes. Adjustment for working capital changes. Some current assets and current liabilities are given. We need to write the difference between them. We begin from inventories. So decrease in inventory, 125 to 115. Decrease in inventories. Inventories are current assets, and in decrease in current assets means inflow of the cash, 10,000 rupees. Then trade receivable, increase in trade receivable. Trade receivable are current asset. And when trade receivable increases, it means cash outflow, 40,000 subtracted. Then prepaid expenses, increase in prepaid expenses, 14,000. Increase in prepaid expenses, 14,000. Prepaid expenses are current assets. It is increases. It means this is outflow of cash. Trade payables, increase in trade payables by 30,000. Increase in trade payables are current liabilities by 30,000. And when current liability increases, it means this is the inflow of cash. So that's why it will be added. So inventories, all points are over. Okay. Now this is the previous year provision for tax is known as tax paid. Fine. So let us subtract tax paid. First, I will do the total. 6,45,000 plus 10 and 30, 40,000 minus 54,000. So 6,31,000. Then what we do? Then we subtract tax paid. Tax paid. Where do we find tax paid? This is the provision for tax, previous year value. This is tax paid, 15,000. So let's subtract 6,31,000 माइनस 15,000, तो वी गेट 6,16,000. देन वी नीड टू एड एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी इनकम विच वॉज सब्ट्रैक्टेड अर्लियर. सो एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी इनकम इज नाउ एडेड बैक. सो हाउ मच एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी इनकम इज गिवन? इंश्योरेंस प्रोसीड्स 50,000, है ना. सो इंश्योरेंस प्रोसीड्स 50,000. And when we add, what we get? 6,66,000. And this will be your cash flow from operating activities. So I hope, dear children, again this question is clear to everyone. One question is enough. Calculate cash flow from operating activities from the following information. So net profit is given, dividend is given, है ना, compensation for natural disaster, depreciation, loss on sale of investment, gain on sale of land, provision for tax, dividend received, decrease in current asset and current liabilities, income tax refund, income tax paid, everything is given. Very good question. So let's begin question number 19. Pay very good attention, dear children. We need to calculate cash flow from operating activities. Okay. So let's see what is given. Net profit is given. ₹8 lakh. Then we need to add some appropriations. So final dividend paid in the year is appropriation. It is given ₹1,10,000. Add final dividend. ₹1,10,000 will be added. Appropriations are added. Then provision for tax is also given, 1,10,000, है ना? This 1,10,000 and then this provision for tax is also appropriation. Provision for tax, 1,10,000. Okay, all points are over. Then here nothing is given. Yes. Then compensation for natural disaster, है ना? So this is extraordinary income. So first I will add these two, 8,09,10,20,000. Okay, this is your net profit before tax. Now we need to adjust extraordinary income. So what we do with extraordinary income? We subtract extraordinary income, compensation received. Compensation received, how much? Compensation for natural disaster, 75,000 is received. So 75,000 is subtracted. There is something else other than this. Income tax refund is also given, which is considered as extraordinary. So income tax refund. Income tax refund, how much it is given? 10,000. This will also be subtracted. So 10,20,000 minus 85,000. 10,20,000 minus 85,000. 9,35,000. Now this will be your net profit before tax and extraordinary items. Now what we do? Now we add non-cash expenses. Non-cash expenses. Let's see what is given. Depreciation and goodwill amortized. So depreciation is given, and now हाउ मच 1,50,000 डेप्रिसिएशन इज गिवन 1,50,000 विच विल बी एडेड गुडविल इज नॉट गिवन है ना देन वी एड नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंस सो नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंस इज ऑल्सो नॉट गिवन यस गिवन लॉस ऑन सेल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट है ना लॉस ऑन सेल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट 30,000 सो वी एड नॉन ऑपरेटिंग एक्सपेंसेस हाउ मच इट इज गिवन 30,000 लॉस ऑन सेल ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट 30,000 इज गिवन देन लेट अस सी गेन ऑन सेल ऑफ लैंड इज गिवन 90,000 दैट इज नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इनकम है ना सो वी सब्ट्रैक्ट नॉन ऑपरेटिंग इनकम हाउ मच इट इज गिवन 90,000 gain on sale of land is given 90,000 that will be subtracted and received this is our non-operating income 20,000 dividend received 20,000 is non-operating income now let us do the total let's see how much we get so 9,35,000 plus 1,80,000 minus 1,10,000 10,05,000 this is our operating profit before working capital changes now we need to do some adjustment for working capital changes so let us see the difference between current assets and current liabilities है ना सो डिक्रीज इन करंट एसेट इज गिवन 40,000 डिक्रीज इन करंट एसेट व्हाट वी डू दिस इज इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश देन इंक्रीज इन करंट लायबिलिटी 70,000 इंक्रीज इन करंट लायबिलिटी 70,000 इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश डिक्रीज इन करंट लायबिलिटी 10,000 in current liability 10,000 this is outflow of cash increase in current assets 60,000 increase in current assets 60,000 that will be outflow of cash so all points are over only income tax paid is left so first we will do the total of these points so 10,05,000 plus 40,000 plus 70,000 minus 70,000 is equal to 10,45,000 and then we paid tax paid less tax paid how much tax paid is given here 1,20,000 so 1,20,000 we will subtract when we subtract 1,20,000 what we get 25,000 10 plus minus 1, 9,25,000. And then what we do? We add extraordinary income. Yes or no? Extraordinary incomes we add. Let's see how much extraordinary incomes are given. Compensation received and income tax refund. So, compensation received. And income tax refund. These two are given extraordinary income, है ना? So it is given 75,000 and 10,000, 75,000 and 10,000. That will be added. So let's do the total. 9,25,000 plus 85,000 is equal to 10,10,000. So this is your cash flow from operating activities. आई होप दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन।